Friends, welcome back. This session is all about understanding what is fog computing, how is it different from cloud computing, how good it is going to fit in into the requirements for IoT. We have been seeing a lot of IoT related things. I think I have about 25 videos for IoT alone. So this makes it very comprehensive, and here addition of fog will also make it little better. So we will understand what is fog computing, the details of it, how it is implemented, the architecture, benefits and challenges, maybe for 15 minutes. What is fog computing? Why do we need it? Where does the necessity come? We have been hailing cloud computing like anything all this time, but now we say that there are issues. So what are those? How are we going to handle it? And how is fog computing fitting into the picture? First thing, whenever we talk about IoT, we get the data generated from lot of different sources. The environment from where the data is generated is all having a lot of sensors, and the data is really, really, really abundant. So the data is abundant, which means it is highly voluminous. First point. Second, the data is generated from variety of sensors. So the data format will also be of different variety. The speed at which the data comes from the sensors, the frequency at which the data is generated is also very high and is variable as well. And the data is having veracity as a feature as well, which means we cannot ever say this is going to be the data, this is going to be the IoT is all complex environment. So you get data from different sensors, you get data from different inputs. So it's going to be four V's now. This is the challenge for big data actually: velocity, variety, veracity and volume. All these four challenges will make you think cloud is little sluggish. So we will have a solution for that, and that solution is going to be fog computing. Now, all IoT applications, for example, most of the IoT applications are for monitoring or for corrective actions. Take a pipeline, oil pipeline. There will be an IoT application that will keep monitoring the sensory data, and if there is a breakage or a leak, it has to take an immediate action, right? Case one. Case two, I have a healthcare application that monitors a patient 24/7. The data goes to the cloud, it get analyzed, and when the patient has a problem, that will immediately call the doctor or take corrective action. These are all some examples. Most of the time, the action that is taken is going to either save the business or save the life. So both are critical. That's going to be a very critical application. Now comes the challenge. We have a challenge here, like the cloud is available somewhere in the data center, and by the time you push all the data to the cloud, get it processed there, you would have already lost the opportunity which could have prevented the damage, because you are taking a lot of time in pushing the data to the cloud and then you are taking action. The time that you take in between generation of the data and pushing the data completely onto the cloud, after which you take an action, is really, really a high time and most heavy time, and most importantly, it could be a golden hour, it could be the golden time that you miss it. So by the time you really process it, you might have crossed the stage where you could have taken the action, or by the time you analyze the things in the cloud, the untowardly event would have already happened, which means the patient would have got a severe attack, the oil pipeline would have already broken. So you push the data, a lot of data onto the cloud, processing happens there. So the time between the pushing the data and the processing the data is really, really, generation of the data and pushing the data is really something very huge. And there is where we need fog computing to sort out this issue. Now you can see the picture that I have got from in the right hand side and the left hand side. The left hand side is called as the cloud. We know this is a cloud and this is fog. What is the difference? Dictionary says that very clearly, fog consists of visible cloud water droplets or ice crystals suspended in the air or at the near earth surface, which means fog computing, fog is very close to the earth. The fog which you are seeing visually in your naked eyes is very close to the earth. Cloud is not so, cloud is far away from you. So the cloud is at a higher level, the fog is at a lower level, and fog is very reachable to you. This is exactly the logic that we have used for fog computing. Now what is done with respect to fog computing? This is natural fog, natural cloud. Let us get into the computing aspect. The most sensitive data which you think are generated from the sensors from all over the IoT environment shall be analyzed at the edge. What do you mean by edge? Edge means the device, the network edge, which is very closer to you than going to the fog. So this makes it possible that the data analysis will happen at the place very closer to its birth, which means I have three layers. Layer one is the data generation layer, layer 2 is the fog layer, layer 3 is the cloud. So the layer 2 is very close to the edge, and I mean the layer 2 is very close to the data generation area, and it will take very less time to reach that. So we are hereby preventing lot of data from the sensory generation, I mean the data generation point, being reached, being a lot of data from the sensory generation point to reach cloud computing. We are preventing that. Instead, we are analyzing all the data in the middle layer, which is called as the fog layer, and whichever is necessary only will go to the cloud. That will be for future analysis, that will be for historical data recording, that will be for prediction, all those things. But the corrective action, the response, everything will happen at the fog level. The fog layer will take all the necessary actions, will read the data, will inform you that there is a problem. Now when there is a problem in the oil line or a healthcare system, it will take lesser time for it to reach the fog, and the results will be much more faster than it reaching the cloud. That's exactly the point. I am now sending it to a middle layer, thereby preventing a lot of time to go to the cloud, and I am sending the ones which are really necessary for me to store for the future. I am not sending lot of stuff into the cloud to unnecessarily dump it with lot of content which may not be really useful for me. Now, the basic requirement for IoT is to get the response in milliseconds. So it would be really possible for me to now process everything in milliseconds, then taking more time. So a milliseconds is what my response time which is required. So that can be done now because it goes to the very closer level of analysis. Now this is how I can explain you the architectural details of fog computing. Now I have data which is generated from sensors, traffic light, laptop, car, healthcare, my mixie grinder, whatever, mixer grinder, kettle, whatever. And then the data goes on to the cloud. It was the earlier setup. Forget about the fog computing. Assume that there are no fog layers here. It goes on to the cloud. Now there will be a lot of processing here, and by the time it processes, the necessary action could have been taken. That's what our point is. Now we have intermediary layer called as fog nodes, which is very close to the data generation point. The data goes here. It will be quickly analyzed. Action will be taken. Whichever data has to be sent for recording only will go to the cloud. Not all the data will go to the cloud. Only the data which has to be recorded will go to the cloud. This is fog node. And you may ask me a question, sir, a fog node needs then computing ability. Yes, it needs processing ability. It needs computing ability because it has to go through the data. That's inevitable. Now, it provides a very faster reply compared to the cloud computing setup. Second, it is safer. In what aspects? If it is going to be healthcare, it is going to protect you from damage. If it is going to be applications like oil line, all those things, it is going to protect the business. So it is going to safeguard you. So the applications that require rapid action definitely can deploy this model. It is very closer that we are analyzing the data, then we are pushing the data to the cloud for further storage, etc. Now, I am going to just give you a quick recall of how does it work. The sensor, the devices, whatever we are using, will generate the data. The data will be transmitted to the fog layer, and which is very close to the source of data generation. These nodes, whatever I am calling as fog nodes, are capable of handling the data, which means they are capable of computing. So they have very minimum requirements. It requires very minimal power and less resources, and that's why we recommended all the data which is going into the fog need not go to the cloud. Now the data can be analyzed. Whichever data requires immediate action can further be triggered for action. Sensitive data, everything will be now analyzed and the action can be taken. And the data travel time is considerably reduced. And whichever data has to go to the cloud can only be filtered, and it can go to the cloud for recording. Fog is not a replacement of cloud. Fog is a subset of cloud. Please understand that. We are not saying that cloud computing is not required. I am saying that cloud computing is still required. Fog will enhance the speed. Fog is not meant for heavy storage, hefty storage. Cloud is still meant for hefty storage. The data that is less time sensitive can be sent to cloud for historical analysis, for future prediction, for data analytics, etc. The fog, the data which is more sensitive, which requires immediate action, will be handled by the fog nodes. And yes, the work done by fog nodes, it gets the data freed from the sensors. All this happen real time. The response time is very minimal, and ideally we expect it to be in milliseconds. Storage is not for lifetime. We don't store the data for lifetime. It is for transit, which means that till the time it processes the data, we can store it in the fog. Data shall be then sent to cloud as summary, which means that I'll push the data whichever has to go to cloud for future analysis. And what does the cloud do? All the data which is sent by fog will be received. The data prediction, the data analytics, big data handling, everything happens here. And now what are all the benefits? First, minimal amount of data is only sent to cloud. Second, when I'm not pushing all the unwanted data, unwanted data all together to cloud, I require more bandwidth. Now when I'm pushing only the data which is relevant, I require less bandwidth. The data latency, which means I'm sending the data only which are important. So the time required to push the data is also very minimal and the latency is reduced. When you have a lot of voluminous data, securing the data is becoming difficult. Now what I do is I handle the data. I have the data only which is of lesser volume, definitely when you compare it to the voluminous data that we had earlier. So securing the data is also very easier compared to the previous setup. Immediate processing of data is also possible when you have limited amount of data and when it happens at the closer place to the edge. Who handles this fog? Who prescribes this fog computing? All those. There is a consortium called as Open Fog Consortium. You can Google about it. There is a lot of information that's available there. Most of the IT majors, say Cisco, Microsoft, they are all members of the, they are all the one who created the Open Fog Consortium and they work for the benefit of it. I hope I have given you the fundamentals of fog computing with the architecture details. I'll come back to you with more material shortly. Thank you very much for following my channel. I'll come back to you with more material and more topics. And if you have any feedback, comments, please let me know. I'll be able to address it. Thank you.